welcome to Daily Current Affairs by Neo IAS. Today is 9th July 2019 and the topic we are going to discuss is National Youth Corps, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, Smart India Hackathon 2019, United Nations Human Rights Council UNHCR, MAP-aided program and the previous year question duration series. So moving to the first topic, that is the National Youth Corps. So NYC, this is in news because this is a scheme introduced by the Department of Youth Affairs and they are implementing this through Nehru Yuva Kendra Sankathan, NYKS. So there was a news regarding this in newspaper. So this is a scheme basically to harness the potential of youth. So bringing them into the main agenda of nation building is a main objective of the National Youth Corps. So, it has been implemented by Nehru Yuva Kendra Sankathan and this works under the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. So, this started in 2010-11 financial year and it was formed by amalgamating two different volunteer schemes. One is National Service Volunteer, that is NSV, and the Rashtriya Sadbhavana Yojana, that is RSY. So, the main objective, as I already told you, is to harness the potential of youth and engage them in the task of nation building, bring that spirit out of them towards nationalism, and also to promote inclusive growth. By inclusive growth, we mean both social and economic growth. Okay. And also, this will be a platform to disseminate the information into the society through youth. And also they can act as a modulator, group modulators or educators for others. And also, they'll act as role model for other younger people also. They can induce more youth to come into the nation building process. These are the main objectives. And talking about the eligibility, young men and women, whoever are there between the age of 18 to 29 are capable or eligible to become volunteers, and the educational qualification is minimum 10th standard, because in order to be an educator or to build a group of youth working for nation building, you should have a minimum set of qualification. That is why they have put 10th standard as minimum qualification. And the volunteer, they'll get paid 5,000 per month for their engagement up to 2 years. Okay. So, they'll be mostly engaged in the developmental activities. So, Nehru Yuva Kendra Sankathan, it was set up in 1987. And this is an autonomous organization. It again works under the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. This is like the largest grassroots level youth organization. And this might be the first in the world, first of its kind in the world. And because they works on the principle of voluntarism, we are doing something without any push from a factor, without any compulsion. We are doing voluntarily because of our commitment towards a nation. So this is more like a community participation system. Okay. So the next topic is Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So this is in news because they have been taken a list of people who have enrolled or filed the Know Your Customer form, and they found out that more than 10 crore people have filed the Know Your Customer forms under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So this is more like 7 crore more connection this year. Okay, so this scheme is basically a scheme to provide LPG connection to women who are who belongs to BPL family, that is below poverty line household. So below poverty line household means at least one person, one deprivation will be there according to the socioeconomic caste census. So this is based on the 2011 database. And this has been implemented by the Petroleum Ministry, Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So this is like a welfare program implemented by the ministry. This was launched in 2016, and what they are doing is they are giving deposit free LPG collection and also a connection. Also they are giving cash assistance. Okay, so deposit free LPG connection is provided in the name of adult woman member of the poor family. So whoever is adult woman in the family, on her name the connection is given, and the beneficiary, they will be available to, you know, have 14 kg or 5 kg cylinder. So the existing beneficiary has an option to switch either whichever cylinder she wants, and it also provides the interest free loan to purchase the stove and the refill by the oil marketing companies. And they have revised the target from 5 crore to 8 crore LPG connections. Okay, and 48% of the beneficiaries, they belongs to SCST. Okay, they have already introduced PAHAL, that is Pratyaksh Hanstantrik Labh. That is also a scheme, that is subsidy delivery scheme to the LPG customer through direct benefits transfer. So the applicable subsidy is given to the beneficiary through their bank account. So what happens, it helped in identifying many ghost accounts, and there was many multiple accounts, inactive accounts. They identified all the ghost accounts and multiple accounts and inactive accounts, and you know, overcome it with only the legible ones. So this has helped in curbing the diversion of subsidies to the commercial purpose, because it was targeted subsidy then. Okay, so they had more money left with, so they diverted it to the commercial purposes. So the government has decided to cover the following categories. So under the scheme, they have like many schemes under this. So all the SCST household beneficiaries of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, they will be getting the benefit. Then Antyodaya Anna Yojana, the beneficiary under that also will get the benefit of PAHAL. Then forest dwellers, the most backward classes, that is MBC, then T and XT garden tribes, they are very poor people, so they are also getting the benefit. People residing in islands, people residing in river islands, these are all poor people in the country, so they are all getting the benefit of PAHAL. Okay, and the main important objective of PAHAL is to help women. Okay, the health of the women, empowering them and curbing their health issue, because they're using fossil fuels and other fuels for cooking, which is very dangerous for their health. So, with Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, they are helping to curb the health issues because of this, and resulting in reduced casualties. And also, they'll help in overcoming their respiratory issues that occurs due to the indoor pollution. Okay, and also indirectly it is helping the sustainable development of environment. Okay, next is Smart India Hackathon 2019. So this is in news because the HRD minister, he inaugurated a 5-day grand finale of Smart India Hackathon. So this is a hardware edition now. So Smart India Hackathon SIH, it's an initiative to bring technology innovations which can help the challenges that has been faced by our country right now. So two institutions are coming together to make the Smart India Hackathon possible. One is All India Council for Technical Education, that is AICTC, CTE, and then the MHRD Ministry. So Inter-Institutional Inclusive Innovation Center, that is I4C, and Persistent Systems, they are organizing the Smart India Hackathon. So through this initiative, the government department will directly engage with technical students, and they'll watch their digital solution to improve the efficiency and curb problems like leakages and corruption. So some of these problems are a solution to predict drought in protected area or things like that. So the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is looking for a solution in telemedicine as well. So that will be also covered here. So it harnesses the creativity and expertise of students. Okay. So this is on the basis of the Startup India campaign and crowdsourcer solution. So they'll provide opportunity to students and also to citizens to bring innovative solutions to work on India's problem. So this was launched in August 2018. It was launched in Delhi, and 96 industries and 18 government ministries and departments, they participated in two editions, And one edition was the software thing. It has 36-hour software product development competition. Then the second one was hardware edition, that is involving the building up of hardware solutions. Okay, so Smart India Hackathon is basically, so they have software edition as well as the hardware edition. Next is United Nations Human Rights Council. So UNHCR is in news because India and Pakistan, they failed to improve the condition in Kashmir, that is being blamed by UNHRC. So they are an intergovernmental body. They work under United Nations system and they promote and protect human rights around the world. And they will solve the issues related to human rights violations, and they'll also make a recommendation for policy formulation of human rights. Okay, so they have the authority or ability to discuss all the thematic human rights issues and situations that is happening in the world in a year. Okay, so the Human Rights Council, it replaced the earlier version was United Nations Commission on Human Rights. So this has been replaced by Human Rights Council. Okay, so this was established in 2006, and 47 United Nations member states are there, and they work closely with Office of High Commissioner for Human Rights, and they engaged in all the UN special procedures. Okay, and the headquarters is in Geneva, and there are 5 regional group which has council seats, and it is distributed according to the geographical locations. And the first one is African states. African states have 13 seats. Then the Asia Pacific states have 13 seats. Then the Eastern European states has 6 seats. Then Latin America and Caribbean states have 8 seats, and the Western Europe, the British part, the Western European states have 7 seats. Okay. So the mandate is that the UNHRC, they have to investigate into all human rights breaches problems, and it have to be, involved in more like freedom of association and assembly related problems, than freedom of expression, freedom of belief and religion, women's right, LGBT right, then the rights of racial and ethnic minority, all of them are under the mandate of UNHRC. Okay, in next is map-aided program. In map-aided program, we are continuing with the Ramsar sites. Okay, today I am dealing with Madhya Pradesh. So, Madhya Pradesh has one Ramsar wetland, that is Bhoj wetland. The Bhoj wetland, it consists of 2 wetlands or 2 lakes. It is in the city of Bhopal, that's the capital city. And the lake are, one is Bhoj Tal, the other one is Lower Lake. So, Bhoj Tal and Lower Lake together is called as the Bhoj wetland. And this lies to the west of the city. Okay. And this is a man-made reservoir. Okay. And around 20,000 birds are observed annually in Bhoj wetland. So Bhoj wetland, it was recognized as a Ramsar wetland in 2002, and the upper lake, it acts like a lifeline of the city. It has 40% of its potable water which has been supplied to the city. And one more thing I have to mention here is there are many birds. I told you around 20,000 birds are there in Bhoj wetland, which is observed in Bhoj wetland annually. So it includes white storks, then bar-headed geese, spoonbills, black-necked storks, then many. Okay, and what happened recently, we spotted Sarus crane also. Sarus crane I have already covered in previous session. So they witnessed 120 Sarus cranes in the lake. So Sarus, the speciality of Sarus crane is that it is the largest bird of India. Okay, it's a majestic flight bird, and it is known for its size. Okay, so that was witnessed in Bhoj wetland recently. So there is a picture of Bhoj wetland. It's not a picture, it's a map depiction of Bhoj wetland in Madhya Pradesh. So it is in Bhopal. Next is previous year question revision series. I'll read out the question. With reference to the Forest Carbon Partnership Facility, which of the following are correct? It is a global partnership of governments, business, civil society and indigenous people. So that is true. Okay, Next statement, it provides financial aid to universities, individual scientists, institutions. No, this is more like an awareness creating program. They are doing some mitigation work, but they are not giving financial aids to university or individual cities. It is a partnership. It's a partnership of various stakeholders for betterment of this forest degradation and emissions due to deforestation. So this is more like a voluntary thing, and it is not giving any financial aid. And if you eliminate the option 2, you'll be done with one A and C. Now come to the third statement. It assesses the countries in REDD plus efforts by providing them financial and technical assistance. Okay, so it assists the countries. Yes, it is not assisting universities and individual scientists. It is assisting the poor countries. That is more like a correct statement. So here the answer is 1 and 3, that is C. So one thing I have to mention here is study environment thoroughly, because these type of questions are expected every year. So I hope you give more concentration to topics like this while preparing for your prelims examination. So you have to identify a wrong statement. Most logical thing, even if you don't know the answer here, the most logical thing to apply here is, why would a forest carbon partnership facility give money to universities and individual scientists and institutions for providing research? So that is not a apt option here, so we can eliminate it. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. I hope you understood whatever I taught you today. So keep reading newspaper, keep watching the daily current affairs session, and keep preparing. Thank you so much. Good night.